chanting, change the world, change the world, change the world. Then silence. Lights. The Reed Sports Palace, 1968. Pedantria of a theatrical performance. Marijuana joint clubs and empty beer cans litter the edges of the stage. Paul Greenwood, 19, sits in the center of the stage in the lotus position. He has long hair and bright face. He has his eyes closed. A long silence. Jeremy Lane, 19, enters holding a crumpled flyer in his hand. He is more clean cut than Paul with a sardonic smirk. He stares at Paul but does not speak. Then,
paradise now, huh?
Jeremy stares at Paul, walks over to him and stands over him, sits down next to him, imitates his lotus position, breaks from the position, laughing.
What a riot. Man, I bet Olin nearly cracked himself. Fuck for peace. Fuck for peace. Surprised he didn't have a heart attack right then.
Can't you see I'm trying to think
about what? Don't say the show because there's nothing to think about.
Darren, that was the living theater.
Yes, I'm aware.
No, you know, the living theater. They
like taking off their
clothes. Don't shave or shower.
They're important. Oh, come on. You can't tell me that was important, that piece of, I don't even know what to call it, that orgy, because it's not important. It's just dicks and bushes, just people screeching in your face and trying to follow you.
It's about connection. Connecting with something outside yourself, with something greater than yourself.
Yeah, that one guy, the one with the hair.
Julian Beck.
Yeah, that one. He seemed real connected, shouting, I am love. And jumping into Sally's lap, trying to stick his tongue down her throat. I am love. Like Jacob wrestling the fucking angel, or like that poor girl turning bright red while some artiste tries to slobber all over her.
You feel like we were all one. For a minute there at least, but like we were working on, like we were included in something bigger than ourselves.
I don't need sweaty strangers sticking their flabby tits in my face to feel a part of something.
You're missing the point. It's showing us that we can take this world. We can take this place. We can do something with it. We can change it. We can change ourselves. We can change everything. This tonight, what we saw, it means something. It's going to mean something for a long time.
Do you think people will really remember this 20 years down the line? What happened here? No. It's fun and it's so controversial today, but tomorrow there'll be something else, something even stranger, more fun than the day after or the day after. This will just be a footnote, a piece of trivia that no one really cares about.
I will remember you and me. That's enough.
It is?
Yes, this moment here, it means something. This place. Not for the people out on Woodstock, not for the people downtown, but for us here now.
They share a silence and maybe a smile, then are distracted by a shot from outside.
Still celebrating. Gonna set the whole campus on fire.
They're just trying to be alive.
But they don't have to try so hard.
When do you leave?
Monday.
Someone will write your transcript. You love this place.
Sometimes that's not enough. Sometimes you have to run screaming for the things that make you feel at home. Like they're on fire and you're covered in kerosene.
Will you visit?
Doubt it. Some places they got too much light in them. Enough to swallow you whole. It's all or nothing with places like that. You turn around, it's all salt.
It's hard with stuff.
And I'm not Lot's wife, I know.
But you will come back. Eventually, I mean, you will come back.
Silence. Then a shout of exultation from outside. Blackout. In the blackout, chanting, change the world, change the world, change the world. Then silence, lights. The Sports Center, 2011. The space is immaculate. Jeremy, now 62, sits in the center of the stage, eyes closed. He wears an expensive but tasteful suit. Silence. Paul, now 62, enters. He wears an old blazer. He stands.
stares at Jeremy and does not speak.
Shot from outside.
Forties night, they call it. You should walk over to Sallyport and check it out. Apparently, grow facial hair. I think they're Keith Richards.
I look loud as ever, too.
You wouldn't believe. Oh, that's you. I'm sorry.
No, that's. You're not even here.
No,
gets up and starts to leave.
Jeremy?
Yeah?
Thanks.
For what?
For coming back.
Jeremy smiles and exits. Paul closes his eyes.